Dear teachers, instructors, trainers, I welcome you to the guideline discussions on what a 21st century instructor should have or should do while delivering a lesson. As you're aware, one of the methods is participatory methodology. And in this methodology, like it is saying, participatory, it is learner-centered, not teacher-centered. So learners have to be more involved in the most of the activities of the day, and the teacher facilitates the process. One of the things in the guidelines, what the teacher should have is a lesson plan. And in this lesson plan, there are very many things involved in it, or there are many things that are encompassed in the lesson plan. There are things like roll call, taking roll call, review of the previous lesson. This one just helps you to know, to see whether the students had a good understanding of what you taught or they understood. You also have to introduce the new lesson. This one, now you are introducing from the known to unknown, the new lesson that you are going to teach today. Then there are also other things like the development. Could have development 1, 2, 3. And then besides those ones, you have the conclusion, all that in the lesson plan. And of course, the working rooms have to be there. So if you are going to teach a practical class, like for example, you are going to teach about maybe stretcher bond that is in building construction, then your students must have safety wear or safety gears on. The safety gears we mean here are the gumboots or the safety shoes, the hand gloves, the helmet, the overall. All these things help the trainees from injuries. Maybe since these materials are heavy at times, like the blocks, you find in the case it happens to fall, it can damage somebody's feet. So it protects the student's feet and the hands from getting injuries, since also the tools are sharp. When all this is assured, or when you are sure that the trainees are well protected, then allow them to take a lead in the creation of the group. Like we said, it's participatory methodology. It is a learner-centered rather than teacher-centered. So give them the liberty, they create the groups, and then you just facilitate group creation. By so doing, you will have put the activities to be done by the learners themselves, most of them. After the groups have been created, you realize that these trainees have to do tasks. And now the teacher comes to facilitate the trainees by giving working drawing. From these working drawings, where the learners are going to look at and follow the steps on what they are supposed to do one by one until they reach the last step. Like we said, in the 21st century skills, the trainees should also be able to communicate effectively. They should be able to think critically, and they should also be creative. Besides that, allow the trainees to have the instructional materials, and the trainees should have their tools. During the demonstration process, the teacher can ask the learners themselves, after they have interpreted the working drawing or studied the working drawing, can ask one of the trainees who has understood to come and demonstrate for the fellow trainees or learners while you are there just facilitating. Learners should ask questions to the teacher. Then also a teacher can ask a few questions, but most questions should come from the learners, so that they can fully get to know what they are supposed to do. The teacher's work is to move around to assess them, see what they are doing, maybe probably guide them. So during the working groups is when the fellow learners can teach their fellow learners. In conclusion, you have to give feedback, but also you ask questions and you give also the answers. Then also the trainees or the learners ask the questions about what has gone on the lesson, where they have not maybe mastered well, and then you give a feedback on their participation. So it is critical, or it is important, that at the end you emphasize on the key points or the main points that they are supposed to follow. These guidelines cut across all the trades that are offered in could be a community training, community polytechnic, could be a vocational training institution, could be a technical institution. They cut across all the trades that are taught there. I'm going to welcome you to watch a video just so as to to enable you understand fully what we have just discussed on about the guidelines for participatory methodology. Once again, I thank you.
Remember last Friday, we said that here we don't have an ignition switch. Do you remember that? And we said we can include an ignition switch in that circuit. We are going to have a switch. This one is outside the reading. It is outside the reading. This one should connect direct here. The reading is this unit here. It is shown by this. Make a wider circle. I told you last Friday that you can test the horn direct. This one has got only one wire, as we said.
Positive.
This one supplies the positive.
Yes.
The negative is supplied by
the board.
How do you call this? How is our battery? Have you measured it? Bring the meter, measure the battery. What is the voltage? It should have an habit of giving us some sound. Let us test another one. But the sounding is not good. Anybody with a status? Test another one. This one has failed. Let us test it again. So how do you conclude about this one? It's faulty. Let me bring the two.
That's right. That's sounding good.
This one here is an adjustment screw. I see it. Let us try to find out whether we can do anything so that can give us the sound. Sometimes if you over tension the diaphragm, it will not have. That one is too loose, but they destroyed it. That just made screw. It was over. They used the longer tool.
Test your switch. Always measure continuity. Good working switch. Put this one here and here. There should be no continuity if you are not pushing. But if you push, there should be continuity. We will press it.
So when you want to measure the voltage, you don't have to.
The easiest way of this one connecting, yeah? Because now that one is an earth switch, it is bringing the negative, isn't it?
Yes.
So that wire which comes from the battery,
positive terminal.
Negative terminal.
Yes.
It is supposed to be fixed on this body.
Yes, we are going to fix it.
So before it reaches this body, it must pass through a switch, because that switch must supply negative. Are you getting me? Then the positive moves for itself without any interruption. But if you make that loop, the moment you connect the battery, it's going to short circuit and the wires will burn out. So now the terminal which comes from the battery and the terminal which comes from the button switch, those two terminals must have continuity on the reading. What do I mean? Bring a meter, I'll show you. There are some two terminals here which have got continuity. So one terminal will be supplying in negative, another terminal will be supplying positive, another one will be terminal which will be going to the host. You select it to continue it like that. You come and measure this and this. Before you use the circuit in this, I mean really in the circuit, you must first test it. Mm-hmm.